Hi, I'm Nathan Cohn from Texas Public Radio and San Antonio's classical music station, KPAC 88.3 FM, here to welcome you to this special concert event live on the internet. As Texas Public Radio and the San Antonio Museum of Art are pleased to present a new orchestral suite by San Antonio composer Nathan Felix. This is going to be fantastic music that I know you're going to enjoy. And we're going to hear from the composer himself coming up in just a few minutes before the music to talk a little bit about it. This is music that draws from the San Antonio Museum of Art's exhibition that's currently on right now called American Impressionism, Echoes of a Revolution. Before we hear from Nathan Felix, we're going to be hearing from Gerald Self. We bring him up here because he is the fella responsible for the four beautiful instruments that you see before us, these harpsichords that will be performed during the concert. Gerald, welcome. Thanks so much for being here.
Thanks for inviting me.
So these are gorgeous instruments, of course. Please tell us a little bit about them. And you have been making harpsichords for over 40 years now. These particular four instruments, tell us a little bit about them.
Well, the harpsichord reached a state of perfection in the 16th, 17th, and 18th century, and it really can't be improved. So all these instruments are plagiarism. They're all copies of other historical instruments. One is Italian, some are Flemish, one is early French. But they all work the same way. They're like a big guitar with a keyboard. Little bird quills plucking the string. So the tone is very precise, very quiet, but very rich in harmonics.
And before the concert started, you were tuning them up until almost a minute before we began, because they're very delicate instruments too.
Well, they're sensitive to temperature, and they were in full sun when I came in, so we're having to chase the pitch a little bit.
So speaking of the sound of these instruments, we're here in San Antonio Museum of Art in the foyer as you walk into the museum. We're about to hear this concert here. What is it like to hear these instruments in this space? Have you had one of your instruments in here before?
A few times, but only just one.
Ah.
But it's nice to be in a museum because all these instruments are copies of instruments that live in museums in Europe.
So, and you mentioned just one instrument, so we have four harpsichords here. Have you had four harpsichords of yours working together?
Four. I usually move one for concerts. Four is a new experience.
So this is a modern piece, obviously, that Nathan Felix is writing, and I think most people, when they hear a harpsichord, they immediately think of Baroque music, something from the 16th or 17th, 18th century. But harpsichord, it seems to work well in modern music, I think.
Well, just like the guitar works very well in modern music, the harpsichord has a very guitar-like quality, that very precise, incisive attack. So you're going to hear very much the sound of a lot of guitars playing.
And it's kind of, there's some of the pieces that may be even reminiscent of Bach, I think, as you hear it.
Bach and his concerto for four harpsichords wrote lots of interlacing arpeggios. You'll hear a lot of that. In Baroque music, there's a style called a chaconne, or a repeating bass line with ornaments on top of that. And then guitar music, you often hear strums and rhythmic, that sort of thing. You'll hear a lot of that. So it's really old meets new. Old instruments used in a very modern way, but very successfully.
Well, Gerald, thank you so much for bringing your artistry here, and we look forward to hearing the fruits of your labor with the music of Nathan Felix.
Look forward to it.
Okay. And at this time, I'd like to bring Nathan Felix up here, the composer of this piece we're going to hear in just a few minutes, to say a few words about it. And Nathan, welcome, and thanks for inviting Texas Public Radio to be a part of this.
Thank you. I'm excited to present this.
So this music ties in a little bit with the American Impressionism exhibit that's happening here at San Antonio Museum of Art. In what way, do you think?
I spent some time here at the San Antonio Museum of Art in their exhibition, and I tried to draw inspiration from some of the impressionistic paintings, and I wanted to take my music and add layers of texture and color, and in that way present sort of a musical version of what I was inspired by.
And you've written pieces for very unique instrumentation. Tonight we have four harpsichords, we have a string quartet, and we have a small choir that are all joining together. Not normally, I think, what most composers work with. I mean, I think folks think, oh, orchestra or a small chamber group or whatever. This is a unique combination of a chamber group, I think, we have here. What draws you to these unique combinations of instruments and voices?
Well, I'm a very curious person, and I think there's a palette of so many instruments that you can choose from. You can mix genres just by, you know, taking harpsichord with choir, right? Two different eras. And I thought, I've done six pianos, why not do four harpsichords? Why not one day do 100 pianos? I'm always looking to push these boundaries, and places like San Antonio Museum of Art and here in San Antonio in general, people have been receptive to my work, and it gives me a sort of a palette to present this.
Can I hold you to that 100 piano piece you just teased?
I've been working on it. No joke. In the garage in the Tobin, I've been begging them, so we should all sign a petition, say, hey, let Nathan do this.
Fantastic. Well, lastly, tell me about what it's been like to work with Gerald Self, the gentleman who's just up here, and these beautiful instruments.
Gerald is an amazing soul. I mean, to think that he allows artists here that are local to come and experiment essentially musically with his his creations, he's a godsend, and I think that that's something very unique and special that I hope people realize that not every city has that, and it's been great getting to know him, and I hope that hasn't been too tall of an ask and that we can work together again. So
fantastic. Well, I really like to hear the music, and I guess I'm going to leave it to you to introduce the players and call them up here.
Excellent. So tonight you will hear a seven-movement suite for four harpsichords, choir, and string quartet. It's called Black Neon Rose. And without further ado, let's bring out conductor Jonathan Martinez and our four harpsichordists, Samuel Gaskin, Daniel Anastasio, Wesley Freeland, and Ed Kanekel.
Oh. You